Hey, you, and welcome. I'm Mr. Barry, and with us today in the studio is my dog, Ushi. Ushi, go ahead and say hi to the audience there. Hello, everyone. All right. So this is Ushi, my pet dog, and today what we're going to be doing is we're going to show you how to add text to your AI-generated art. Now, as you may or may not know, this channel is driven by you, the viewers. And so people write in questions on how to do things, or if they have a question about technology or computers or anything, they leave it down in the comments, and I read those comments and I make a video based on the question or comment. So if you haven't thought about that, you can think about it right here for a second and then leave a question down in the comment section there on anything to do with technology, or it may be about EVs, computers, phones, or AI, or anything else like that. So KLP asked, Mr. Barry, how do you add text to your AI-generated art? And so here's the example I made. And it says Tesla. And since now Tesla has dropped in price now, you can, after everything there, you get around $35,000. So, hey, I thought I might as well make a billboard, and here it is. So that's what I did there. I also made another one on space. Pretty neat. So today what we're going to do is, since I have Ushi in the studio with us today, I thought I could go in and create a billboard about dog food and have a image of a dog on a billboard, maybe in a city scape or country, doesn't matter there. And then we're going to add the food, the words, perhaps like Ushi's dog food or something like that. Sounds like a plan? All right, well, let's figure out and learn how to add text to our AI-generated art. Hey, here we are inside of the Night Cafe user interface there, and I'll have the link to it down in the description for you, so you can just click to it and get right to the Night Cafe's website. They do have an Android app as well as other types of apps, such as for your iOS and other things there that you can actually download and use it that way on your computer if you need to. Now, once you're here, click on the red button there that says Start Creating. And if you haven't done so already, it'll allow you to log into your particular account so that you can see your creations. And here we are inside of the user interface to actually create our works of art. Now, if you notice over on the left-hand side, you have an option at the very top. We're going to be using the advanced option so we can add multiple prompts when we need to. So go ahead and click on that one there. And then if you notice there that we have the model 1.5, you can use different models. Sometimes I use the 2.0 or 2.1 there, the stable diffusion, and it does give a different effect to the whole artwork. Maybe I'll make a video on that if you want to in the future. But for right now, we're using 1.5, and then I'm going to be adding the words there for the prompts and seeing if we can make a billboard with some dogs in it so we can add words to it on the next go around. So on the settings for this one, I am going to be using the advanced mode, I'm going to be using the stable, and then for the model, I'm actually going to go all the way down to SDXL beta for this demonstration today. The text I want to use.
Billboard that has a happy dog, styled by Makoto Shinkai, James Jean, and John Baptiste Monge Green Park. Bright, cheerful colors, elaborate, oil painting.
I'm not going to be using a start image. I'm going to be using just one. Now, if I needed four or more, you notice that does some will cost more credits, but I'm going to go with one. And for the runtime, I'm going to be short. And the aspect ratio, let's go widescreen today. For the overall prompt weight, yeah, 90%, that sounds good. And let me see here. Now, just to let you know, if you're out of credits, you can always go in and use like one of these stable diffusions 1.5, then it's a free generation there. But since I do want to try this new one that just came out the other day, the SDXL, then it does cost 0.75 credits. But you get credits every time you log into Night Cafe. Basically, you get 5 credits free. So anyway, let's go ahead and click on create and see what it makes. All right, it's made this creation here and I love it. Look at this, we have a city in the background, the Eiffel Tower, so this could be Paris, Gay Paris. And I have a, looks like a river, people are in the river. Then there's this pathway right in between us and the river. There's a car parked there, people walking on this path, trees, and there's my billboard in the center with a happy little terrier. There's another dog here, I think. And here's some a building or a structure in the park. Looks like I can add some text up here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add some text. So what I want to do on this is I'm going to click on evolve. And once I've done that, if you look over to the extreme left-hand side, you notice some things have changed. One is the model has changed to the stable in painting version 2.0. And I do have other options in here, but it's changed to that because it's now going to be using the mask. For my text prompt, I need to change that because I want to add a word. So I'm going to click on Advanced Prompt Editor. Now we come up to here where we see our prompts. I'm going to click on Add Another Prompt. And this one's going to be the word Ushi. So I'm just going to type in Ushi. On these here, on the weights, I'm on the very first one, I'm going to go 0. And then this one is that 1. That's okay. Going back to the left-hand side, there's my start image. I'm going to click on that. And I now need to add a mask. So I'm going to click on choose or create a mask. And I want my word to appear around here somewhere. There we go. So I'm going to have it in this area. You have to click on done and then it will change to black. There we go. Now it will be able to apply that word. So we're going to go over here and it says noise weight. I'm going to go to 100, but I have seen really good results at 50% and also even at 30%. So kind of experiment at this point. On this one, I'm going to choose 100%, but on yours, you can keep it at 50% and kind of play around with any numbers between 30 and 70%. And so I'm going to go up to 100% on that. I'm going to make only one image, thumbnail, short run time, and this is a free creation as you see at the bottom here. Can't change the aspect ratio because we are using a startup image and it will be using the same ratio, aspect ratio, as the original image. For my overall prompt weight, I can bring that up. Normally starts around 50%, but I'm going to bring that up to 90%. And then for the seed, it says use a random seed for each creation. I'm going to say yes. The reason why we do that is because the very first time you do it, a lot of times it doesn't put the word in there or it puts it in and it's unreadable. So it takes a few times to create, and that's why I'm using a free creation here. So I'm going to try a few here. Let's try the first one. And I see nothing there. Let's try the second one here. All right, so after about three times of trying this, it came up with the word Ushi, as we see up here. And that is awesome. So we have the word Ushi. And what I'm going to do is I need to add the words dog food. So we have Ushi, dog food. And so I'm going to click on evolve again. And go to the start image, and this time I'm going to choose a new mask, and I'm going to have it where it says dog food. I'm going to have it right here. So Ushi dog food, it's going to be appearing right here. I think that will be very attractive to have it there. Click on done. Now I'm going to go back to the advanced prompt editor. And for the word Ushi, I really don't need that any longer, right? We don't need that. So now I'm going to say For this one, I don't want a bowl of dog food because it might think that I want a bowl of dog food or a picture of it. So I'm going to say print. And then within these quotations, I'm going to say dog food. So print dog food. Now, I know KLOP, she's asked, can we change the font? And I think the font is rather random. But if I went in and typed in something like Romans or something like that, it might know what to do it, but it might not. Like New Times Roman or something like that. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to type in print dog food. And I'm going to check to make sure it does say stable in painting. So I still have that. That's really important. If you choose one of these others, it will not work. Just to let you know. Now for the noise weight, I'm getting the best results. The clearest letters actually at around 50%. You can, like I said, you can experiment between 30 and 50% on longer words. One image thumbnail, short for the runtime. And again, I need to change that seed over and let's click on create and see if it makes it. All right, so there you go. Now it says Ushi dog food. And you have this beautiful billboard here and this little cute dog and another dog. I guess it's a happy dog over here. People walking, this is a awesome creation. So you have something that you've made here. And now you know how to add the text there. As far as changing that font, I was thinking that if you go back to the advanced editor there and then actually say font and say New Times Roman and then do something like that. It may do that. I have not had any success, but basically with the AI, it's hit and miss. Normally it takes at least 5 to 10 times or creations, I should say, before it gets all the words in there and they're legible. A lot of times it just writes random letters in there and you just like, wow, you get kind of frustrated. But this actually worked here. So let's go back to this. And this is really nice. I'm really happy with this. So now you know how to add text to your AI art there. It does take a few times, I should say, and click on that create button over and over again. So since you're doing that, I make sure that I click on creating only one image at a time. And I usually use the versions to make it free there on the settings. And so keep on trying there until you get the text and the font to be just the way that you want it to be. So if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up. And Ushi says hello there. So if you want to see more of Ushi, by the way, you can just leave a question down there or a comment saying, hey, we want to see more of Ushi. And we'll be sure to add more Ushi there in the future. So if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel and share the video with others there on your social media. All right, well, thank you again, everyone. Y'all have a very good day. Bye-bye.